One of your main goals in this module, in your learning, is to learn how physicists think about motion. So motion is something you might think that you've got a pretty good handle on. You know, you're pretty good at thinking with terms like speed. You might think you already know what it means to have acceleration. And you might already imagine using words like force or energy or momentum or and, right? And some of you sometimes might even use some of these words correctly. But for the most part, the way people naturally think about motion, it might be really good for surviving, say in a city, you know how to avoid being hit by a car, or in sports, it might help you know how to get in front of a frisbee so that you can catch it, right? As the frisbee moves over the field. But the point is I bet you for the most part, you are not actually using these words exactly like a physicist uses them. Physicists are really, really, really careful. They, in particular, for example, they think very carefully about motion. So some words that honestly, you shouldn't quite be using yet in our class, although they are going to show up later, definitely, is words like energy and momentum. There's definitely something about motion, you know, it sort of goes without saying that energy and momentum have something to do with motion, but we are going to concentrate on words like speed, and acceleration, and a very particular word, at least in the beginning, known as the velocity. And the velocity, if you can figure out why this is so important at the beginning, you will be well on your way to understanding motion like a physicist does. So physicists have a very careful way of thinking about motion. The natural way that people think about things moving around in the world is from something of a point of view. That is, here is a person, there's their eyeball and their nose and their mouth, and they are standing somewhere watching nature happen. And they might look up and see the moon, right? And they also see a car, right? And say the car is driving by really fast, say at 60 miles per hour, right? And this person compares the motion of this car and the motion of the moon. So for this person, and their point of view, they would say, actually, the moon seems to not be moving at all. It seems to be at rest up in the sky. And the car on the street traveling at 60 miles per hour is going really, really fast. And if they look down on the earth, they'll say, well, me and the earth, we are both standing still, right? This is something of a point of view problem. The moon, actually, in real life, if you're a physicist, you would be able to sort of realize this. The moon is traveling very much faster past this person than this car is, even though the car looks like it's going much faster. It looks like that because of the point of view. But if you took more of a physicist perspective, you would think about all these issues about moving and motion from more of a map perspective. And what you would imagine is on a big map, somehow you would imagine the Earth being here and the moon, say, being here. And you would see that the moon was moving really, really fast compared to the tiny little car that was right here on the Earth, moving only at 60 miles per hour. And I challenge you, actually, what is the speed of the moon compared to the Earth? You can look this up on the internet. Just for fun, why don't you go look it up, right? And that gives you something of a perspective of why thinking about different things moving on a map, right? More like a Google map or just a, you know, you think of the large space perspective. I wonder if you can see why this is interesting compared to this point of view version. Okay. Yep. Yeah.